Do you expect to leave me standing on some beach with nothing but a name and your word? It's the one I need, and watch you sail away in my ship.
No. I expect to leave you standing on some beach with absolutely no name at all, watching me sail away on my ship, and then I'll shout the name back to you. Savvy?
But that still leaves us with the problem of me standing on some beach with naught but a name and your word. It's the one I need.
Of the two of us, I am the only one who hasn't committed mutiny. Therefore, my word is the one we'll be trusting. Although, I suppose I should be thanking you because, in fact, if you hadn't betrayed me and left me to die, I would have an equal share in that curse, same as you. Funny old world, isn't it?
Still thinking of running, Jack? Think you can outrun the world? You know, the problem with being the last of anything, by and by there'll be none left at all.
Sometimes things come back, mate. We live in proof, you and me.
Aye, but that's a gamble of long odds, ain't it? There's never a guarantee of coming back. But passing on, that's dead certain.
Summoning the Brethren Court, then, is it?
Our only hope, lad.
That's a sad commentary in and of itself.
The world used to be a bigger place.
The world's still the same. It's just less in it.
How's that escape route working?
Here's your chance to improvise.
I'm attempting it.
I might be able to get a hand loose. Oh, you got a knife. That's very good.
Better.
I want one of those. Here's to revenge. Sweet and clear.
Revenge.
Come, come, Hector. If you wanted the chalices, you'd seen they were missing and gone. You were lying in wait for Blackbeard.
Oh.
King George, privateer, Whig. Cheap theatrical facade, I'm not buying it.
You weren't there that night.
When the pearl was lost.
Taken, not lost. We were off the coast of Hispaniola when we came under attack. No provocation, or warning, or offer of parley. We were peppered with cannon fire. And then the sea beneath the pearl began to roil. The pearl was pitching and yawing violently. Every plank, every rail, every spar all at once began to creak. The rigging had come to life. Our own ship turned against us, tangling the crew, wrapping around them like snakes, and wrapping around my leg. But my arms were free and my sword was to hand. I am the master of my ship, not Blackbeard. I am the master of my fate, not Blackbeard. So I did what needed done. I survived.
So, you're not after the fountain?
I care not for King George or Tavernions that give hope for a healed limb. That give me left arm for chance of Blackbeard.
Not your right?
I need my good arm to drive my poisoned blade through his heart.
I'll see you get the chance, mate.
Smith? Smith is quite an unusual name, Jesus. Did we not once know someone called Smith?
Shut your trap.
What's her name? It's right on the tip of my tongue.
Oh, do you want to lose that tongue?
Margaret Smith.
Aye.
Shall we make an accord then? Or shall I tell you know who what we both know to be true?
We both take this secret to our graves.
I mean, it is true. I was bluffing.
I'm not.
You kill me, you got nothing to bargain the dead with. So you need me. I'll have to be frightened, Hector. You are very, very ugly. So how could you produce a fetching creature such as that?
Margaret died. I summoned as much honor as a worthless blackguard ever could. I placed the infant in an orphanage, never to see her again. I thought the ruby might afford her some ease in life, but I never imagined she'd take those scribblings and make a life of her own. Life that's led her back to me.
I'd say this puts me in a rather favorable position, Daddy.
Tell me what you want.
I want my compass. 216 barrels of rum. And the monkey.
You want Jack?
Dinner. I want to eat him. I want to eat that monkey.
No deal, Jack. A clever young woman such as that would never believe that a swine like me could ever be her blood.
And the trident will be mine.